This is the world's largest photovoltaic solar farm built by China for $280 million. Unlike traditional photovoltaic power plants, it is not built on land, but entirely in water. There are thousands of photovoltaic panels floating in this vast water area of nearly 13,000 acres. The electricity generated here every day is enough to support the daily electricity consumption of 700,000 people. Its capacity can almost meet the entire power needs of a medium-sized city. So, why should PV be built on water? Will such a huge floating photovoltaic power station cause water pollution? If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. In recent years, extreme weather phenomena caused by global warming, marine pollution, and industrial emissions have become more frequent and have become a hot topic of concern to the international community. Faced with warnings from nature again and again, human society has been forced to initiate a far-reaching self-reform. At present, many countries around the world have begun to make carbon emission reduction the core of their development strategies. For example, the European Union was not only one of the first economies to set long-term emissions reduction targets, but now has 11 member states that have set specific years to achieve carbon neutrality. According to the latest data in 2023, the EU's renewable energy power generation already accounts for 44% of the total power generation, of which wind and solar power account for 27%, which is a record high. In addition, some countries in Asia are also actively promoting low-carbon development strategies and carbon neutrality goals, including China. As a country with a population of more than 1.4 billion, China has realized the importance of renewable energy very early, so they have invested huge efforts in the fields of wind energy and solar photovoltaic power generation. In 2012, the Chinese government invested $300 million in the construction of the Talatin photovoltaic power station in the desert of Qinghai province. The project covers 78 square kilometers, equivalent to an area of 10,000 football fields. In 2018, China completed another ambitious project in the desert of Dunhuang City, Gansu Province, the Dunhuang CSP. This power station consists of 80,000 mirrors and is one of the largest photothermal power generation bases in Asia. Under all weather conditions, the Dunhuang CSP power station can provide up to 100 megawatts of electricity, with an annual power generation of 390 million kilowatt hours. Of course, China's photovoltaic industry not only has a profound impact domestically, but its advanced production technology and cost-effectiveness also enable it to occupy a leading position globally. According to 2023 data from the International Energy Agency, China's photovoltaic product exports reached $47.59 billion. Especially in Europe, China's photovoltaic modules account for the vast majority of the market, with exports to Europe accounting for 90% of market demand, with exports reaching $13.08 billion. But China's innovation in the field of photovoltaic power generation has not stopped. They have even introduced a revolutionary technology, building large-scale photovoltaic power plants on the water. In the wind and photovoltaic base in the south of Fuyang, Anhui, China, is located one of the world's largest single floating photovoltaic power plants. The project was started in 2017 with a total investment of $180 million. The entire floating photovoltaic power station is built in a coal mining subsidence area covering an area of 13,000 acres, using 1.2 million photovoltaic modules. This huge project covers an area equivalent to 1,300 standard football fields. By 2018, the power station will be completed and connected to the grid at full capacity, becoming the world's largest floating photovoltaic power station. As far as I know, this photovoltaic power station currently consists of 122 ultra-large photovoltaic arrays, with a total installed capacity of 650,000 kilowatts. Every year, the power station generates an average of 700 million kilowatt-hours of electricity, and its daily power generation is enough to meet the electricity needs of 700,000 people. This is equivalent to saving about 220,000 tons of standard coal and reducing carbon dioxide emissions by about 580,000 tons per year. In addition, this floating photovoltaic power station can not only improve power generation efficiency and reduce water evaporation, but also help protect aquatic ecosystems and increase biodiversity. In the energy structure transformation of China's Yangtze River Delta region, floating photovoltaic power stations play a role that cannot be ignored. Therefore, after having previous successful experience, China immediately built a new floating photovoltaic power station. In China's Shandong province, two key solar photovoltaic power generation projects are progressing in an orderly manner. These include the floating photovoltaic power generation project in Dingzhuang Reservoir in Texas and the photovoltaic power station in Lizhou Bay, Yantai City. Particularly worth mentioning is the power station in Lizhou Bay, which is a landmark project. According to the project plan, the power station will be constructed from early January 2024 with a total area of 6.44 square kilometers and composed of 121 photovoltaic subarrays. This project is not only huge in scale, but also one of the first batch of offshore photovoltaic projects in Shandong Province, China, with the deepest water depth, the most difficult construction, and the most complex development conditions. This project reflects China's advanced capabilities in offshore photovoltaic technology. It is expected that after completion, the Lizhou Bay Power Station can generate 690 million kilowatt-hours of electricity per year, which is equivalent to reducing the consumption of standard coal by approximately 207,000 tons and reducing carbon dioxide emissions by approximately 532,000 tons per year. This will not only make a huge contribution to the environment, but will also provide a strong green impetus for the economic and social development of Shandong Province and even China as a whole. You may be curious. China has a vast land area of about 9.6 million square kilometers and a sea area of about 4.73 million square kilometers. Why does it choose to build solar photovoltaic projects on the water? What are the advantages of photovoltaic power generation on water? In fact, due to the preciousness of China's land resources, the government has set up a red line for cultivated land protection to ensure that a certain amount of cultivated land is properly protected. However, if you want to build a photovoltaic power station outside the urban area, you must occupy a large area of land, which is detrimental to the development of the city. Although Northwest China has vast grasslands and deserts and is relatively rich in land resources, the area is sparsely populated and the demand for electricity is not high. In contrast, electricity consumption is mainly concentrated in the densely populated eastern areas, and the land in these areas has been extensively developed and is not suitable for the construction of large-scale photovoltaic projects. Therefore, innovatively building photovoltaic power plants on water has become an ideal solution. Of course, floating photovoltaic power plants offer a number of significant advantages over traditional land-based photovoltaic power plants. In fact, the natural conditions of the lake are very suitable for the construction and operation of photovoltaic power plants. The lake surface is usually flat and open, which can effectively reflect sunlight and has almost no obstructions, allowing solar panels to operate at their best and greatly improving power generation efficiency. Additionally, floating photovoltaic power plants are extremely cost-effective. Since this type of power station is built on the water, it saves land acquisition costs and significantly lowers the investment threshold. In general, Floating solar panels usually have a service life of at least 10 years. But during this period, there is little need for additional expenses other than basic maintenance costs. Therefore, in the long run, this kind of floating photovoltaic power station is also an important direction for sustainable energy development. Interestingly, China's newly built floating photovoltaic power plants also play a key role in ecological protection. Engineers carefully designed the layout of photovoltaic modules to enable these power stations to cover large areas of water bodies, effectively reducing water evaporation and thus saving precious water resources. In addition, in the absence of sunlight, this helps inhibit the excessive growth of algae in the water, maintains clean water quality, and protects the underwater ecological environment. Under these waters covered with photovoltaic panels, using their environmental advantages for aquaculture has become a new economic growth point. Because the shading effect of photovoltaic panels can reduce the water temperature by about 2 degrees Celsius, this not only provides an ideal living environment for aquatic animals, but also helps reduce common diseases in aquaculture. This model that combines photovoltaic power generation and aquaculture significantly improves farming efficiency and profitability. Local people said that through this innovative model, the annual income from shrimp ponds per mu can reach $5,000, which is almost 3 times the income from traditional aquaculture. Up to now, floating photovoltaic power generation technology has become an important trend in global sustainable energy development. In this field, not only China has made remarkable achievements, but Europe is not far behind. Recently, the Netherlands successfully commissioned Europe's largest floating photovoltaic power station, which was built on an abandoned sand mining lake with an installed capacity of 27.3 megawatts, becoming the world's largest such project after China. At the same time, Singapore is also actively promoting its 60-megawatt floating photovoltaic power station built on a reservoir and will be completed in 2021. According to predictions from photovoltaic industry organizations, by 2024, the cumulative installed capacity of floating photovoltaic power stations worldwide will reach approximately 4,100 megawatts. Although this still accounts for a small proportion of the total installed photovoltaic power generation capacity in the world. However, with the continuous advancement of technology, cost reduction, and the continuous accumulation of design, construction, and operation experience, floating photovoltaic power generation technology is expected to become an important direction in the field of renewable energy. To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.